Hello everybody, Paul Ducklin here. Last year, Sophos looked into Wi-Fi security by sending one chap on a bicycle right across London and sending me on foot to tramp the Sydney CBD north to south, east to west. We found that while things weren't exactly terrible, they weren't 100% rosy either. So we thought that to coincide with the 2013 Cybersecurity Awareness Week in New Zealand, it was worth doing some revision. So here you go. Three wireless security myths. Myth number one, hiding your network name, or your ESS ID as it's known. Many routers will let you do this, and it does mean that if someone does a regular search for wireless networks, yours won't show up. And that means that some people use their network name as if it were a password in its own right, so they don't have to bother about encryption. But the problem is that every time you join your own network, you actually send the network name openly over the airwaves. So hidden networks aren't actually hidden. And a wireless sniffer like Kismet or Aircrack can map them out for breakfast. So repeat after me. Network name hiding is for safety, not for security. Myth number two is MAC address filtering. Every network card has a 48-bit media access code, or MAC address as it's known, burned into it in the factory, and this MAC address digitally identifies all the network traffic from each device. That sounds jolly handy, doesn't it? So much so that some people try to use MAC addresses as if they were passwords. The idea is, for example, that you'll add your friend's MAC address to a list on your router, and then they can log in and they don't need to type in a password, they don't need to remember anything. But there are two giant problems here. A, the list of MAC addresses on a network is a matter of sniffable public record. And B, even though they're known as hardware addresses, MAC addresses can trivially be changed using software. And that means those guys in the office next door, not only can they work out all the MAC addresses on your network, they can borrow them too. That means they can pretend to be one of your PCs and jump onto your network without you realizing. So repeat after me. MAC address filtering is for safety, not for security. And myth number three is wireless encryption using WEP. Now, coffee shops and that sort of place, they often have open access points, and they use them as a sort of perk for their customers. But if you're running a business, or even if you're just organizing your digital life at home, you don't want people who just happen to be in the neighborhood to be able to sniff up all your network traffic and look at it at their leisure later. And by the way, if you need convincing that that sort of thing goes on, just ask the guys at Google Street View. Now, the good news is that wireless encryption is easy to set up, but the bad news is a thing called WEP. The WEP encryption system has turned out to be fundamentally flawed. It's completely broken. It can be automatically, quickly, and easily cracked. Don't use WEP. You should choose WPA or WPA2. And they come with a thing called a PSK. That's a pre-shared key. And that's the password you want to pick. Make it a good one. Mix up some letters, digits, and some wacky characters. Make it long and tough to guess. And don't be afraid. It's not that hard to remember 17 characters. Thanks for listening, folks. Please try to make Cybersecurity Awareness Week into a digital lifestyle choice. And until next time, stay secure.